March 13, 1997. A night that thousands of people witnessed one of the strangest UFO sightings in recorded history. This is why. The Phoenix Lights Phenomenon. Across the skies of Arizona, Nevada, and part of Mexico, between 7:30 and 10:30 p.m., thousands of people reported seeing strange, bright lights flying overhead. But it wasn't just one event, there were two. The first event was described as a V-shaped object the size of a commercial plane soaring through the sky. One witness said he watched a boomerang-shaped object glide over a mountain range, and it was at least a mile or 1.6 kilometres wide. According to him, there's no way it was from this planet. "We don't have anything that big," he said. "It was totally silent. I've never seen anything even close to the colours from the exhaust that propelled that thing. It completely blocked out the stars." The second event was reported by an unidentified former Arizona police officer who claimed he saw a series of stationary orange and red lights hanging over the valley. Video shows what looks to be an arc of lights appearing one by one, then going out one by one. UFO believers claim that these images show that the lights were some form of running light or other aircraft illumination along the leading edge of a large craft. A significant number of witnesses reported that the craft was silently gliding directly overhead at low altitude. The first-hand witnesses consistently reported that the lights appeared as canisters of swimming light, while the underbelly of the craft was undulating, like looking through water. The Phoenix Lights were treated as a joke at first by then-governor of Arizona, Fife Symington. So much of a joke that he had a staff member dress as an alien for a press conference about the phenomenon, all to laugh at how ridiculous the claims were. But Symington later did a complete about-face. He claimed that he had seen the lights himself, and he believed that they were from an extraterrestrial source.
"No, I'm serious. I'm serious now. That it was unquestionably a UFO, which means unidentified flying object.
Right. Doesn't mean we're being visited.
Well, it's nothing like anything I've ever seen."
The orange and red lights were later explained away by authorities as flares dropped by military aircraft during a training exercise. However, the V-shaped object remains unexplained. One person who witnessed that UFO, Dr. Lynn Keitai, has spent more than two decades investigating this phenomenon.
"Number one, we're not alone. That's the most important thing."
She does not believe the military's explanation that the lights were simply flares.
"You're trying to say that flares, military illumination flares, that traverse the entire state in a rock-solid, mile-wide V, equidistant formation for hours?"
Former Arizona Governor Symington also rebuffed the flare theory, writing in a CNN piece that the lights were not flares, saying they were, quote, "certainly not high-altitude flares, because flares don't fly in formation." It is a mystery that remains unsolved to this day, and a UFO sighting that is one of the most intriguing ever recorded.